New challenges, new drivers, new teams, and a new track to start the season. Welcome to the 2017 TCR International Series. 20 races over 10 race weekends. And it all starts here at the Rustavi International Motor Park in Georgia. Some familiar faces are back in the TCR paddock, while there are some newcomers too. Some drivers have changed cars and teams, like the double TCR International Series champion, who switches from a Leopard Racing Volkswagen Golf to an Audi RS3 LMS, run by a new team, Come to You Racing.
I want the triple. I want the third title with the third different car, and I'm here to do again my job.
I'm quite confident. The car is good. I have already good feeling with the car.
I'm happy to be in the back with Seat and with Lukoil. It's one of the top teams.
Many changes, but I think and I hope good changes for the season.
So I'm proud to participate here in Georgia. For me, it's great honour.
Our aim is always to win the championship at the end of the season, but we take round by round and maximise our points at each event.
I want to learn as much as possible, and I really like this series, and I'm looking forward to do the best I can.
The two-hour testing session on the Friday gave drivers and teams the first chance to drive the 2017 cars in anger. Some enjoyed the luxury of familiarity, while for others, the session was all about learning. In the end, the 10 fastest cars were covered by a little over 6/10 of a second, confirming that the series has the potential of being closer and more exciting this year.
We will have some work to do the first two races.
I think we will have such a good fight this year, much better than the last 2 years.
I want to be focused only to learn the tracks, the cars.
Overall, I think we've got a great package, and it will be nice to see three red cars right at the very front.
To win the championship, which is the main goal this year.
The event sees the TCR International Series make history by being the first international motorsport event ever held in Georgia. Only the local hero, David Kajaia, has any experience of the Rustavi International Motor Park, but racing drivers are fast learners.
It's quite a technical track, not so high speed in the straights.
The tricky parts are in third sector for me, because there are slow corners.
In the second corner, which is a really, really long corner.
Fast corners, I like fast corners.
The gap between all the drivers will be very close.
The Rustavi International Motor Park is a 4.1 kilometre track, rebuilt around 6 or 7 years ago at a cost of around $25 million. 12 corners and some long straights combine to deliver a tricky start to the season. Saturday afternoon might have had an air temperature of only 12 degrees, but at least qualifying would be dry. Despite all the other changes, qualifying remains the usual two-stage affair for 2017, and it was Gianni Morbidelli's Volkswagen that led the cars out of the pit lane. First to set a quick lap time was Pepe Oriola in the Kraft Bamboo Lukoil Seat Leon, but less than halfway through the 20-minute Q1 session, there was a taste of things to come when David Kajaia went quicker than the G-Force Alfa Romeo Giulietta. Next, it was the turn of Roberto Colciago to top the timesheet in the Mira Honda Civic. But it seemed the last-minute deal for Come to You Racing to run the Audi RS3 LMS meant Stefano Cammini was struggling to find a decent setup. The double TCR champion improved to sixth for a while, but at least he would go through to Q2. Not so fortunate was Kajaia's compatriot Shota Abzakava. The owner of the circuit spun at turn 4 and so wouldn't be in the top 12 at the end of Q1. With a little over 5 minutes of Q1 remaining, Hungary's Ferenc Fikcsér was the quickest driver in the Zeller Racing Seat, but would soon drop to fourth. 2 minutes from the end, Colciago retook first place, with his young teammate Attila Tashi second and Kajaia snatching third in the dying seconds. Dusan Borkovic was 13th, slowed by broken steering, and so he didn't join Kajaia in Q2. This was how Q1 finished, with the two Hondas of Colciago and Tashi ahead of Kajaia's Alfa Romeo and Fikcsér's Seat. Cammini and Valente also went through to Q2.
It's so difficult to drive, so I drove two laps on my muscles and, and that was that, so I couldn't go into the... If I get into the Q2, I couldn't... I could not drive, so for me it's the same.
At only 10 minutes, the second stage of qualifying is always frantic, with no margin for error. The grid for race one is decided by the result, while the top 10 is reversed to form the grid for race two. Tashi had earlier been fastest in the second free practice session, and he looked like repeating that feat with just under 6 of those 10 minutes remaining. Kamini used every trick he knew to get a good result, and he went second fastest, thanks to this toe from James Nash. It was therefore Tashi and Kamini lying first and second, when, with less than 4 minutes left, David Kajaia drove the perfect lap to go nearly 6/10 of a second quicker than Tashi to grab the provisional pole for race one. Gianni Morbidelli's hopes of a front row ended in the gravel at turn four, with a little over 2 minutes remaining, while Fichtcher made it two Hungarian drivers in the top three by qualifying 8/1000 of a second behind Tashi. This is how Morbidelli ended up in the gravel, but he'll start race one from 7th and race two from 4th, so a good result is still more than possible for the Italian. In the end, Kamini was 6th fastest, so he'll also be in the hunt for points in both races. But the happiest man in the paddock was Kajaia. Pole position in front of his home fans meant he was delighted, as was Giacomo Altoe, who'll start race two from pole, thanks to qualifying 10th. Just to confirm the qualifying result, Kajaia was fastest from Tashi and Fixer, Vernet, Colciago, Comini, Morbidelli, Valente, Oriola and Altoe.
David Kajaia, what a great result. Pole position at home. You must be very happy.
Yeah, I'm more than happy. I'm proud to be in pole position in my country. This is unbelievable. This is amazing. Thank you for my team, for a good car. And I will now concentrate for tomorrow's race. And I will try to keep this position for the race also.
Ahead of the race weekend, there was a glimpse of the interest in the event when 6 of the TCR cars and 15 drivers gathered in the centre of Georgia's capital, Tbilisi. An autograph session and a chance to meet Georgian fans and the Minister of Interior Affairs were followed by something new for TCR. All 6 of the cars were escorted through the city streets by police motorcyclists, something that was met with approval by fans and drivers alike. Hello and welcome to our television audience around the world. Welcome to the Rustavi International Motor Park here in Georgia for an historic event, the first international motorsport championship event ever held in Georgia. And the honour falls to the TCR International Series. And you see in the foreground a very popular pole sitter. That is David Kajaia, known as Data here in Georgia. And the hashtag GoDataGo has been trending in Georgia for the last week or 10 days. And he has put the G-Force Alfa Romeo on pole position for race one. Alongside Kajaia on the grid will be Attila Tashi, the 17-year-old from Hungary in the Honda Civic. Row two, Ferenc Fichtcher, another Hungarian in a Seat. Jean-Carl Vernet alongside him. Row three, Roberto Colciago and reigning TCR champion Stefano Kamini. Then it's Gianni Morbidelli and Hugo Valente, newcomer to TCR International, on row four. Row five, Pepe Oriola and the 16-year-old Italian who will be on pole for race two, Giacomo Altoe, James Nash and Matto Hommola. There they go. Green flag is waved. We're waiting for the lights to go on. When they go off, we are racing. Watch for that start. Can Kajaia get the jump on Attila Tashi? Will the 17-year-old Tashi lead into the first right-hand turn one? Lights go on. Lights go off. We are racing in 2017. The TCR International Series is underway. That was Giacomo Altoe, the young Italian in the dark blue West Coast Racing Volkswagen, who just came out slightly. Good start from Kajaia. A little bumping and banging in the field. Oh, and Comini makes contact with Jean-Carl Vernet, the former teammates. Kamini in the Audi, Jean-Carl Vernet in the familiar turquoise Volkswagen Golf. There is Kajaia, Tashi behind him, then it's Fichtcher, 1-2-3, as we saw on the grid. Then it's Colciago in the second of the Mira Racing Hondas. Then it's Kamini, then Vernet, then it's the first of the Kraft Bamboo Lukoil cars. Oh, more contact. This time it's Valente with Borkovic muscling his way through. Kajaia's advantage, 8/10 of a second already, as Tashi defending from Fixture. Kamini having a little look, but there's no real prospect from there. Oh, he dives up the inside! Kamini up alongside Colciago, and he passes. So Kamini takes fourth from Colciago. Now, I really didn't think that was on. Colciago must have made some kind of mistake. Let's just take another look at that start. Catch our breaths for a moment. Brilliant start from Kajaia. Fixture moves across, but no, can't do anything about Tashi. He blocks nicely. And it was Kamini who moved right across to the right of your screens. And this is the moment. There it is, the contact between Kamini and Vinay. And I think that was almost certainly a racing incident. I don't think there was any way that could have been avoided. Contact too between Borkovic and Valente. And it's Nash now all over the back of Valente's car. Can Nash get into the points? Oh, Valente slides wide, allowing Nash to dive up the inside. You see just how tricky these conditions are. That's at turn 12, the left-hander that gets us back onto the start-finish straight. Pierre-Yves Courtals also gets past, and Fixture now, while we were watching that battle, Fixture has moved into second place. So where did that happen? Fixture having passed Tashi. So it's still Hungarian drivers 2 and 3, but it's now Ferenc Fixture in the Seat, ahead of Attila Tashi in the Honda. That's the contact between... Oh, sorry, that's the moment that Valente slid wide going into turn 12. As Kamini dives up the inside, does he? Does he keep the line? Is there enough room? Only just! Kamini and Tashi alongside each other. And he does it! Kamini moves past, squeezes past. Brilliant driving from the Swiss driver. Kamini then takes third place, so away from a disappointed Attila Tashi, as Valente is in the pits getting attention. And it's Fixture looking for a dry line towards the right-hander at turn one. The two Hondas up alongside each other. Colciago goes through. Once again, Tashi runs slightly wide. So Colciago snatches fourth place from his teammate, Attila Tashi. Colciago moves up alongside, looks up at the inside of Kamini, but no, indeed, doesn't make it stick. So still, Kajaia from Fixture. Colciago this time does dive up at the inside of Kamini. Has he grabbed third place? Kamini on the inside for that long left-hander turn two. No, indeed, Colciago runs slightly wide. Kamini holds the place. This race isn't over yet. We might be on the last lap, but those podium positions are far from decided. Kamini holds on, as does Kajaia. Around turn 12 for the final time, to the cheers of the crowd. There is the checkered flag. And across the line comes David Kajaia to take his first victory. And you can hear the reaction of the Georgian fans. Brilliant, brilliant drive under pressure from David Kajaia in the Alfa Romeo Giulietta. David Kajaia, winner of the first round of the 2017 TCR International Series. Let's take confirmation then of the results of this first of the rounds of the TCR International Series for 2017. David Kajaia wins from Ferenc Fixture. Stefano Kamini finishes third. Roberto Colciago, Attila Tashi, Jean-Carl Vinay, Pepe Oriola, Giacomo Altoe.
David Kajaia, what a fantastic day for you and for Georgia today.
Yeah, it's amazing, it's unbelievable. Look at this, how many people. I'm very proud. In my country, in Georgia, first win in TCR International. I have no words. I'm really, really more than happy. Thank you for everything.
There is the smile, I thought. There will be the hug. David Kajaia. Look at that smile, that says it all. That's what that victory means to him. And a controversial episode following race one here at Rustavi. because at the press conference following the race, Stefano Cammini, extremely negative, very critical of behaviour by Jean-Carl Vernet. And you see there repairs going on to the Audi. Cammini alleging that there was contact on the slowing down lap, which we didn't see. And so he reckons that Vernet caused him to run into the back of him and damage the radiator on the Audi. So at the moment, you see Cammini there, fifth on the grid for round two. But if you look at the grid itself, you'll see that there's a gap on the third row. So the Audi still not out. There he goes. So once the field goes through, they'll release Cammini. He'll start from 16th behind the rest of the field. The lights go on. They're off, they're racing. Altoe gets a slow start, I think. Across goes Pepe Arreola, but indeed Altoe beats him to turn one. Through comes Tashi in the blue Honda. There's contact, Tashi spins. Was that contact with Vernet? Vernet indeed tucks in behind Tashi. There is Morbidelli in the second West Coast Racing car behind Vernet. But indeed, it's Giacomo Altoe, 16 years of age, only his third season of racing. He started in karting back in 2015, and there he is leading a race of the TCR International Series from the two Craft Bamboo Lucor cars of Arreola and Valente. There's Tashi in fourth. Arreola has the line. No, indeed. Altoe blocks. Brilliant move from the youngster. Valente has a look. Is he up alongside Arreola? He's squirreling under braking, is Valente. And Cammini already a 9 second or so gap behind Indy at the back of the field. Tashi taking a look around the outside of Valente, but there goes Jean-Carl Vernet up the inside of Tashi. Has the Volkswagen got the place? No, indeed. Tashi has the line for the right-hander. And there's our lead changing hands. It's Pepe Arreola and Hugo Valente going up the inside of Giacomo Altoe. The experience shows Altoe comes back, but Valente moves across to block. Altoe moves across. There is a safety car. There is contact in the background. Nobody seems to have gone off. And that's the reason for the safety car. And that would have been at the start. So he's into the gravel at turn one. And that would have been right at the start. There is Hommela out of the car and walking back to the pits. Here they come then, up to the start line. And Altoe moves across. We're underway again as they turn into the right-hander at turn one. Tashi then, just tucked in behind Altoe. There is Vernet. And there is Morbidelli. So everybody tightened up thanks to that safety car period. As Altoe runs slightly wide over the curbs, Tashi, though, not close enough to take any advantage. Around turn 12, they come onto the start-finish straight. Tashi alongside, but it's the right-hander turn one, remember. So it's Altoe who is alongside Vernet, and Tashi takes the position. Tashi moves up into third. Altoe drops to fourth, just ahead of Vernet. So there is Tashi, Altoe, Vernet, then Borkovic, who's passed Morbidelli. Cammini now just outside the points in 11th, and there goes Altoe. Ran wide and threw into the gravel. I'm wondering if his tyres were shot. I was just about to say that I didn't believe where Cammini was on the leaderboard, but that would be why. So Cammini in the pits and a very frustrated end to his race. We'll, I dare say, find out from him. Nash dives up, down the inside of Morbidelli, just sees the gap and goes for it. So Nash takes the place from Morbidelli. And that's the moment from a reverse angle of James Nash going up the inside of Morbidelli. Calciago moves to the left of Morbidelli and takes the place. He has the line, he takes the place on the left-hander. through turn 11, into turn 12. Colciago takes the position from Morbidelli, who's now under threat from Ferenc Fikcher. Tashi then third, Vernet fourth, Borkovic fifth, sixth is now Nash, seventh is Colciago, eighth is Morbidelli, coming under pressure from Fikcher. Kajaia looks to be comfortable in 10th, and so he will potentially take a position as Fikcher goes past Morbidelli. Now, is there a problem? Are the tyres starting to go off on the Volkswagen? That seemed rather too easy. And there's the door opening. Thank you for that, says Fikcher, and through he goes. Around turn 12 they come, the drag up the start-finish straight. Nash, it would appear, has the legs. The Seat powers past the Alfa Romeo. Colciago, too, takes a look up the inside. He has the line for the right-hander. So Colciago passes both of them. Was there contact between the pair? A little nudge, possibly, from Nash. Colciago loses the position, but keeps going. Let's take a look at that again. Nash on the right of your screen. Colciago, they slow. You know, I'm not even sure that there was contact. That may have just been last of the late breakers just outbreaking himself for that right-hander at turn one. And that's where Fikcher went past Nash. Nash takes a look up the inside as they go around turn 12. Now, this will be interesting. Seat versus Seat. It's the 2016 car that loses out to the 2017 model. Nash takes the position. Colciago moves through as well. So, Nash into sixth, Colciago into seventh. Ferenc Fikcher down to eighth, ahead of Morbidelli and Kajaia. So all change. Ferenc Fikcher just takes a little look. Was there a tap there? Let's just take another look at that. Because there is contact. Colciago backs off. There is contact there, and off goes Fikcher. And I originally thought that Colciago had a problem with the rear of the car where the contact was. And indeed, there is Fikcher. His race is over. Borkovic, Nash and Colciago running together. Kajaia still ahead of Morbidelli. And Colciago moved past Nash, but almost lost the place again. As Kajaia takes a look up the inside of Nash as well. So the position changes. Colciago takes sixth away from Nash on this last lap of the race. Let's just take a look at that again. Colciago diving up the inside of Nash. Nash turns in to find the Honda there. Looks like he's going around the outside, but this time Colciago didn't make the same mistake of the late braking. Judged it to perfection and takes the position. As Pepe Oriola takes the checkered flag from Hugo Valente. Third is Tashi, brilliant drive from him, holding off Jean-Carl Vernet. And so it's Oriola, Valente, Tashi, Vernet, then it's Borkovic, then Colciago, Nash, Kajaia, and Morbidelli. Let's see what kind of celebrations we get from Pepe Oriola. Yes! I did think he'd be pleased with that. There is confirmation of the result to round two of the TCR International Series. Pepe Oriola taking victory from Hugo Valente. Attila Tashi third, ahead of Jean-Carl Vernet, Dusan Borkovic, Roberto Colciago, James Nash, David Kajaia.
Pepe Oriola, winner of race two and keeping up with the tradition of winning always in the first event.
Yes, thank God. I can achieve a win here, even if it was everything against us. The first race in rain, and at the end it was a little bit dry, but even in the start was really, really hard because my line wasn't dry, so the start was so hard to keep Hugo behind. But yeah, really happy with the result. At the end we found the pace of the car, because yesterday in qualifying we missed a little bit of pace against the front and most with the other Seats. And now today, in a race, in a 10 lap, I did the time as I did yesterday in qualifying. So I think we found the setup, which is a good thing for us for the keep coming year.
Mikhail getting out of the way. The fireworks go off. The champagne is sprayed. After the race, the stewards judged that Valente had indeed overtaken Altoe under yellow flags. but that Oriola's pass occurred before the flags came out. Similarly, Colciago's last lap lunge up the inside of Nash into turn one occurred after the yellow flags were displayed, so both Valente and Colciago received 30-second penalties.
There's the yellow flags at turn one, and Colciago came past me and overtook. So I think that would be disallowed, but a few laps before, I managed to just get past Dusan, which is always very difficult. And he came down the inside all locked up on the wet and nearly took me and Dusan off, which scuppered up my plans with Borkovic.
Those decisions mean that Oriola's victory still stands, but Tashi moves up to second place and Vinay is now third. In the Drivers' Championship, Kajaia now has a 6-point lead over Tashi, with Oriola a further point behind in third place. Two very different but incident-packed races then to start the 2017 TCR International Series. Thoughts are already starting to turn to the next pair of races in Bahrain on April the 15th and 16th. But for now, from Rustavi in Georgia, it's goodbye.